Okay, so I am back. I am tan. You probably can't really tell yet because it takes time to develop. I'm just kind of bundled up. I got this cute little black fuzzy cozy thing from Amazon. So it's nice and warm. I just got my black jammies on, some black pants, and I'm just making some turkey and rice for dinner, and then I'm gonna have some rice cakes with peanut butter on it afterwards, as my last snack. And I'm gonna put some nails on. I just do the stick-ons, glue-ons, whatever they are, because I don't get my nails done. I do my own acrylics actually. I just didn't do them this time because I've been busy. And I'm gonna paint my toes and watch some Netflix and just eat some food and just chill. And that's basically gonna be the end. I wasn't gonna come on here again because like my hair is a mess and it's like I blow-dried it. Oh God, I'm looking at it on the side. It's a mess, but it's okay. I'm gonna do it tomorrow. I'm still not sure if I'm gonna do it curly. My boyfriend's bringing me some hairspray. And yeah, so I don't know. The first show I did some little curls and they were cute. I felt good. And the second show I did it straight. So I think what I'm gonna do tomorrow is just straighten it and then see how I feel and then maybe I'll curl it afterwards. Because I use this little iron that's kind of like a straightening iron. And I just kind of like roll it through and it holds the curl really good, but my hair's a little shorter this time, so I just don't want to look like a bobblehead because I'm lean or like Curly Sue or whatever. I don't know. So yeah, I'm just gonna chill for the rest of the night. I'm gonna make some food. I guess I'll show you my last couple of snacks. And I'm just watching Netflix. I got Netflix on. I just turned it off so that I wouldn't get copyright because I'm watching The Chilling Adventures of Sabrina, which I've watched before, but you know, I didn't watch the last season of it, so I'm gonna watch that. And I gotta finish my water and look at this cute little mug. I got a cute little mug. Battle of the Gods. They must know I'm a mug hoarder because I'm a mug hoarder and I get mugs everywhere I go. It's kind of a thing. When I used to live with my mom, she'd yell at me and be like, "No more water bottles, no more mugs." So, well, whatever. I got another mug. So my turkey's cooking. I'm gonna have some turkey and some rice, and then a rice cake, two rice cakes with peanut butter, and just put my feet up, relax, do my nails. Next time you see me, you'll have nice nails. And just gonna do a neutral color on my toes. I had this like teal nail polish on before. So I took that off earlier today. So I'm just gonna chill, paint, relax, look at my suits. I still don't know which one I'm gonna wear. They're both so pretty. The last competition, all I had was the royal one, but the top was a little bit small because I ordered a small because I really like my boobs were shrinking. So I thought they were gonna shrink more, but they didn't shrink as much as I thought they would. So the small kind of looked, I don't know. I thought it looked weird. I don't know. In pictures, it looks fine, but I thought it looked a little bit small. So I have two suits now. I just showed them. I have a teal one that's got like blues and purples in it, so it's really pretty, more like a jewel tone. And then I have this bright purple one that I got during Angel Competition Bikini's last suit drop, like a month or two ago. Because they do suit drops all the time, and that's a great time to get a suit. Like, if you see a suit you like and they have it in your size and your cut that you want, that's like the best time to get a suit. They are having a Black Friday special that early access starts now if you use my code Alicia L. I'll show that below so you can use my code. It's good for 25% off of practice suits, competition suits. I love the practice suits because you can wear them to the pool, you can wear them to the beach, wherever you want. And they have that same cut so you won't get weird tan lines that won't match with your competition suit if you're competing in the summer, which I competed twice in the summer. So I had to wear my practice suit to the pool because don't want to have those weird tan lines that the tan can't cover up. So I will see you guys tomorrow for the show day vlog. Let's go. I'm so excited. I'm so excited, so excited, so excited. All right, it's show day eve. Let's go. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the vlog. Today is show day. So today is gonna be a show day vlog. I have been up since about 7:30, 8 o'clock. I laid in bed for a little while. Got up, weighed myself. I was 130.4, which I was hoping for a little lower, but at this point, numbers don't really matter. It's more about how we look. I had my normal breakfast of oatmeal, protein powder, egg whites, a little bit of apple flavored protein, and some apples with a big scoop of peanut butter on top. And then I just started doing my makeup. I'm actually ready really early. This is the earliest I've ever been ready for a show. It's currently 11:45 and I'm ready. I'm completely ready. So now I just get to sit and chill and relax until my boyfriend gets here, and then he's gonna drive to the show. So I was trying to decide between two different shoots. Suits. Suits? Oh wow. Wow, prep brain. Hi. Two different suits. I have a teal suit and I have a purple suit. So, what did we decide to go with? We decided to go with the purple suit. So, I love this suit. I got it at the Angel Competition Bikinis suit drop over this, well, it wasn't over the summer, I guess it was a couple months ago. But yeah, we decided to go with purple. Purple. It's so pretty. Because purple is the color of royalty, and when I'm on stage, all jeweled out, I feel like a princess. So, and I've always wanted to be a princess. So, you know what? We're gonna go with purple. I'm gonna bring my teal suit just in case there's any mishaps or anything. It's always, always, always good if you're a new competitor to have a backup suit. My last competition, I always brought a backup suit, even though it wasn't as sparkly and it wasn't the bottom cut that I like. It was a Brazilian cut because it was the first suit I bought and I didn't really know anything when I bought it. So I always bring a backup suit. So I am bringing the teal suit. My sparkly shoes are packed, so I've just been wearing my old shoes that are just plain for check-in. I just checked in with my coach again, and yeah, so it's early, so I got so much time. I'm probably just gonna lay on the couch and throw some Netflix on. I'm probably just gonna leave this top on though. And just try to be careful because I don't want to be changing too much because I don't want to mess up my tan. So, like I said, I had some oatmeal. I'm not sure what we're gonna eat next. Probably just stick with rice cakes, peanut butter, and really that's it. Probably just rice cakes, peanut butter, maybe some honey. I have some Skittles for pump up, and Alan is bringing my Halloween candy that I didn't get to have any of. And my herder tequila, because we gotta have a little tequila before we go on stage. Just a little bit though, like half a shot. Because it actually does help with pump up for me, anyways. I noticed that the last time I did a shot of tequila, I'm not a huge drinker, but last time I did a shot of tequila, my veins like were just like, yeah, hey. And so I got a good pump from that, so I was like, maybe I should have like a little, just a little bit, because we don't want to go up on stage and be like, woo, we're drunk. No, because at this weight, you get, you feel it quick. You don't need much. So, yeah, that's kind of it. I got most of my stuff packed. I think right now I'm just gonna go and put together an outfit to change into at the venue after I get off stage and after I take pictures and everything, so I don't have to go home in my suit and this, because I'm just gonna wear this with my suit and then my black sweatpants to the venue, and then I'll put my bottoms on one when I get there, because I don't want to be sitting in the car in my bikini because it's just awkward and you don't want to make lines or anything. So I have my black sweatpants on, they're really loose, and I'll just put my bottoms on when I get there. So yeah, I don't have anything really going on today. Now, 12. He's gonna be here around like 1:30, and then we're probably just gonna go because, I mean, what's the point of just sitting around? Might as well get there early in case the show's running early. The last show I did with OCB actually did run a little bit early. Like I think they said they were gonna start at 3:30, and I think it started like right before 3:30. So I always want to be there early so that worst case I can just see where they are in the lineup. I have the whole lineup. See where they are in the lineup, and just be ready. Just get my suit, bottoms on, and just go sit on my blanket backstage and throw some headphones in, chit chat with people. I have a couple of friends. I have one friend that is from the last show that's going to be competing, and I have some new friends that maybe will want to chit chat. I don't know. I don't know how everybody vibes. I tend to talk too much when I'm nervous. So if I'm nervous, excited, I talk a lot. So hence why I'm probably talking a lot right now. So yeah, I just want to kind of get there, and I feel like once I get there, a lot of the stress just goes away because I know all we have to do is pee, touch up tan, eat some snacks, pump up, and then just go do the thing. So I'm super excited. I'm really excited for today. I did my nails last night and I painted my toes. They're just kind of like a whitish pink. So yeah, that's gonna be it right now. I'll keep you guys updated as the day goes on. Okay, so I'm back still. Nothing's really happening. I have some turkey and some rice that I'm gonna eat so that hopefully I can go to the bathroom before I leave. It is 12:53, so we're probably gonna leave around like 1:30, 1:45. And I just took some check-in pictures. That's not gonna focus. Come on. Yeah. There we go. So, I'm very, very happy with how I look. So, we want to keep it nice and tight, and still be able to get a little pump. So, my shoulders really pop when I have carbs and when I get a pump. So I put some salt on here and some mustard. So I'm just gonna eat this and then we'll see where we're at. And I'll probably just go back to laying on the couch because that's all I've been doing all day today. So I've been chit-chatting with them, so it's super great. So I'm gonna send my coach some pictures and then see what she wants me to eat. And there's a little break right now, and then they're gonna do the wellness division, and then it's gonna be us. Go time.
Let's do it. Let's do it. 67 and 54. Please switch 67 and 54.
So good.
Please walk to the front of the stage.
Yeah,
53 and 60, please switch. 53 and 60.
Yes, Alicia!
Please turn and face the rear of the stage. Please walk to the back of the stage. Fifty-eight, 61, and 62.
Alicia!
Woo!
Woo! Please walk to the front of the stage. Face the back of the stage.
See if you're on white.
53. Yes, Alicia.
Please walk to the back of the stage. We have number 61 and 58 switch. 61-58. We have 47 and 48 also switch. 47, 48. And please turn and face front. Please walk to the front of the stage. Please turn and face the back of the stage. Please walk to the back of the stage.
Yeah, go on. Nice.
Woo! Fun time!
Can we have 51, 61, 53? Please turn and face front.
Get nervous right now.
Killing it, Alicia! 53, baby! 53!
Please walk to the front of the stage.
You got this, Leash!
Yes, mama!
Let's go!
53 and 61, please switch. 53 and 61. Please try to face the back of the stage.
Come on, 53, you got this.
That's Alicia.
And please walk to the back of the stage. Please turn and face the front.
Awesome, 53.
And in first place, competitor 53, Alicia Lard.
Yes, Alicia!
Yes, 53!
Yes!
Okay, ladies, let's squeeze in a little tighter. Bring your awards with you if they're kind of far away from you. Beautiful. Great job, ladies. You can step up.
Girl, I'm legit sobbing. I'm trying not to mess up my makeup because I still have to go for open awards.
And in first place, competitor 61, Elizabeth Chanley. All right, ladies, squeeze in. Beautiful job. Top five, open.
Post-show update. So, if you follow me on Instagram, you will see our results, and I have some fun stuff to show you. And then we're gonna try some treats and just talk about what's next. And my heart is just so full right now. I'm so happy. I can't believe that this prep, I went through so much in my personal life, and I went through so much emotionally and just with everything that went wrong and my contract job ending and not sure what I really want to do with life. I pushed through and got these results, and I'm so proud of myself. I literally could not be more proud of myself or happy about how this went. Like, I'm still kind of on cloud nine. I'm just so happy. So I competed in Masters 35 plus, and I also competed in Open, and my friend Elizabeth competed in Open, and I am so happy to say that both of us got our pro cards. So we are your two new OCB pros. I got my pro card in Masters 35 plus, which qualifies me for the Yorton Cup, and it also qualifies me to compete in any other Open pro shows. So with the OCB, if you get a Masters pro card, you are still eligible to compete in the amateur Open unless you compete in a pro Open using your Masters pro status. Then you can no longer compete in the amateur Open, but because they allow Masters pros to compete in any Open pro shows, there's really no point in trying to go get a pro status in Open because I can compete in all the pro shows. So first we got Masters 35 plus Class B first place award. So I got first in my class for Masters 35 plus, and that qualified me to go to the overall. So I was in the overall with actually one of my Instagram friends that I've been chit-chatting with over these past couple of months, and I ended up winning the overall. So this is my big warrior trophy. She's very heavy. She weighs like, I don't know, 10 pounds. So that is my pro card, official OCB pro. And then in the Open, I got second place in the Open, Class C. So there's Class A and B, and I was in Class C, and Elizabeth was in Class C as well. And she ended up winning. I got second place. She went to the overall, and she won her pro card. So it's so funny because when we were in the back, I was chit-chatting with my friend Katie's coach, who was had an athlete in novice or novice debut. She had an athlete in debut, so I was talking to them, and it was so fun because my friend Katie competed a few years ago in WBFF, and she won her master's class. So, you know, I'd always seen her coach on Instagram, and then I met her in the back and was talking to her and her athlete, so that was super fun. Elizabeth got there, and she was like, I want my pro card, and I was like, I want my pro card. I was like, oh my god, I'm gonna cry. We both want our pro card, and we're both in the same class, so it's not even like both of us could go to the overall. And I was like, well, you know, because the rules are that Masters pros can compete in any pro open show, and the Orton Cup, which is goals for 2023, is to do a pro debut and then do the Orton Cup and just work so hard and just keep doing this sport because I love it so much. I love the structure and the discipline of prep. I love seeing the changes in my body and what I can do if I push myself, even through everything I've been through. So we were in the back, and I said, I really hope I win my pro card in Masters 35 plus, and then in the open that you get first in our class and I get second, so that I still have a good placing, but then you go to the overall and you win your pro card. And lo and behold, that's exactly what happened. And it's so crazy because I'm so happy that I got my pro card, but I'm also so happy that one of my friends got my pro card, and now because she doesn't live far away, we're gonna hang out and train together, so it's gonna be super fun. So then after the show, we took some pictures. Me and my boyfriend took some pictures, and I didn't get a picture with Katie or Elizabeth or anyone because everything just happened so fast. And then I went and changed. I ate a drizzle cookie in the car because I was so hungry. And then we went and got some pizza, mozzarella sticks, a couple of drinks, and then went home. And the next day we had plans to go to breakfast at Tea's, which is kind of like a really cool, I wouldn't say like an upscale breakfast place. It's in Narragansett, but it's like a nice breakfast place. And I just wanted the ooey gooey French toast because it's like basically a cinnamon bun that they turn into French toast and put all kinds of icing on top of it. And I had home fries and bacon. And if you go on my Instagram at @AliciaLaird_, you can see all of the highlights and everything from that on there. I didn't take my camera with me the next day because I just wanted to, my boyfriend took the whole weekend off, so I just kind of wanted to spend the whole weekend with him and just actually have some quality time together where we didn't have to worry about me being restricted or having to get certain things in at certain times. So he said he had a surprise for me. Really, all we planned on is breakfast. So we went and had breakfast, and it was so good. I'm probably gonna drop some pictures in here of the food. And then I was like, oh, I just wanna get a coffee, which actually we never got the coffee. We never got the Mary Lou's coffee that I wanted, but at the breakfast place, it was amazing. It was a pumpkin spice spiked latte, and it was spiked with, I don't know, actually, I really don't know, but it was really good. And it has whipped cream on top because, hey, why the heck not? And then I guess he had some other stuff planned, which I wish I had known that I needed more jacket than I brought, because I only brought my lightweight jacket, and I wore just Tom's shoes, and it was like 30 degrees, so no body fat, freezing. So we ended up leaving the breakfast place, and then I was just like, where are we going? And he's like, it's a surprise. So we headed out into Connecticut, and we had been talking about going to Clyde's Cider Mill for a while and getting cider and treats and everything. So we ended up down there and spent about an hour there just kind of walking around, trying different ciders. And we went into the store and we bought some ciders to bring home for the holidays. And I got this giant peanut butter cup. It's like this big. I didn't bring it over with me because I'm not gonna eat it right now. I'm gonna save it a little bit. I'm probably gonna cut it up a little bit and freeze some of it, or because it's gonna keep. I definitely need to eat my donuts though and fudge because we got that in Mystic. So after we went to Clyde's Cider Mill, we just wanted to stay down there, and we went to Mystic Village and just walked around, and they were putting all the Christmas lights up. And so at sunset, after we had gone around to a bunch of the shops, we got some fudge. That's what I got. I made him take the rest of it home because I just wanted to keep some little pieces of it. But I'll show you the fudge in a moment and my donuts. And so we walked around, and then we were gonna go to Go Fish for dinner, which is one of our favorite places, because I was like, ooh, lobster roll, sushi. And they were closed. I don't know what's going on. I guess they're moving locations, so we were trying to figure something else out. And it was really cold, so, but we went to all the different shops, and I gave him some ideas for Christmas. So we did that, and then we headed back up to Rhode Island, and he was like, oh, I have an idea, I know where we're gonna go, and then he wouldn't tell me again. So it was a lot of surprises yesterday. It was fun. It was fun to not have to worry about, oh, well, I don't know if this surprise is gonna fit into my macros, so, because we're just taking a little chill day. We're chilling. Even today, I'm not going to be perfect on my macros because I don't want to waste all my yummy food and treats and stuff. So I can still see my lady over here. Oh my God, can you believe this? That is so cool. I'm going to get emotional because I can't believe after working this hard, I've been on prep for, I've been dieting for probably 43 weeks. I started my prep in the January, and yes, I did take a little bit of time to have treats and cheat meals, or free meals I should say. It's not a cheat, it's a lifestyle, you know, can't be perfect all the time. Between after my last two shows and a little bit of when my dog died and when I lost my job, and I just like I had some pizza and stuff, so whatever. And I still came back and won my pro card. And I really just want to let you guys know that even when life is in the toilet and you're having, like, I had so many breakdowns between the last show and this show, between especially regarding my career and my work life and my bartending job, that, like, it just... I went through so much emotionally, and every weekend when I go to work, I have to deal with just so much emotionally, and it's very hard to handle sometimes. So the fact that I went through all this stuff during prep and am still trying to figure out my life, plus I was studying for the NASM and I passed the NASM. So I passed that about a month ago. So then I was studying, stressed about passing that. I passed that. And now it's exciting because what's going to happen next? I'm so excited for my future because I know, yes, maybe things are a little confusing and weird right now, and I still just don't really know what to do. But now I have lots of time because my contract job did end, sad. But now I have more time to focus on education, and I want to take some marketing certification classes that I'm in online, and I want to get through some business classes that I have for photography, for my photography business, and hopefully get out of the job situation that I'm in right now so I can really focus on myself and physically and mentally, really especially mentally, and get into a better place financially and career-wise before I go into another prep next year. Because we do want to do the Yorton Cup, but that's in September, so really, we have tons of time. We have so much time, so that's the goal. I don't know if I'm going to do my pro debut at the Hall of Fame, which is the show I did earlier this year. It was in July in Springfield, and I really liked that show, and I really liked the promoter, who's also the promoter for this show. So I could do my pro debut there in July and then take some time off, reverse a little bit into then go into another prep for Yorton Cup. Or there are some pro shows that are right before the Yorton Cup, like within a couple of weeks. So I could do like a pro debut as a warm-up show and then obviously just don't have crazy amounts of cheat meals, maybe do like sushi, keep it clean, and then go into the Yorton Cup. And I do want to do some NPC shows next year too. So maybe one, maybe two, I don't know. I feel like three or four shows a year would probably be my max. Unless I'm not working on the weekends anymore. And then if that's the case, then that would be great. So with all of that said, oh, I do have one more thing actually, before we dive into this fudge a little bit. Because I did get my personal training license, I am going to start taking online coaching clients. So online coaching will be nutrition, workouts, motivation, inspiration, because I feel like I am my own product of my own hard work. And if I can do it, anybody can do it. And all I want to do is inspire everybody else to be the best they can, no matter what life throws at them. And that you can do it. You just have to work on your mindset, which is something I have really, really struggled with, especially this last prep. So if you are interested in one-on-one lifestyle coaching, I'm not doing bikini prep. I will do bikini posing, because with my dance and ballet background, I feel like my posing has come so far and I could help so many people with that as well. So I will be taking posing clients and I will be taking online coaching lifestyle clients as well. So if you are ready to change your life, I will put my contact info. I'm still working on a website for it, but I will put my contact info down below so you can send me an email for coaching or posing, or you can shoot me a DM over on Instagram at @AliciaLaird_. So that was, I wanted to say that before I forget, because now it's just fun. Okay, so we went to Mystic, and Mystic has this general store that has fudge, and I did have some yesterday. So we have three fudges here. We have peanut butter and chocolate, pumpkin spice, and moose tracks. So we're just gonna take a little bite of each and sample and review. I already know which one's my favorite, but you know, we're gonna just do it on camera. Chocolate and peanut butter is my darn weakness. It's so good. Okay, so Moose Tracks is kind of similar. It's like a white chocolate fudge with peanut butter and chips. I think I like the Moose Tracks better than just the straight chocolate peanut butter, because it does have that crunch and it has a little more texture and variety. Pumpkin spice. I know pumpkin spice can be a little weird sometimes. You never know, like, if it's gonna be good. Winner, pumpkin spice. If you are in Connecticut or Rhode Island and want to take a nice little day trip to Mystic Village, go to the general store. Pumpkin spice fudge, get it. Not paid to say that. It's delicious. I've been going there actually since I was a little kid, and we always got fudge. All right, next up. I haven't had these in forever. I hope this is focusing. PVD donuts are the best donuts in Rhode Island. Need donuts are also really good too. But when I had my first encounter with PVD donuts shooting weddings, and I don't want Dunkin' Donuts because Dunkin' Donuts is like, it's like floury. These donuts are bomb. So we have pumpkin spice something cake brulee. Let's give it a try. Okay, that's good. Oops. Gonna have to go in for a little cleaning on my couch. We have peanut butter cup with peanut butter cup filling. I'm actually gonna cut this one because I'm gonna make a mess with these last two. Isn't this how you do it when you're really cool on like Instagram or something? We're just gonna get right into the good part. I'm making a mess. I don't have a lot of time to film this though because it gets late. I mean, it gets dark so late. That's delicious. I don't know what this frosting is, but it is peanut butter frosting. Mmm. Look at that middle. Whoops. Wow. Like I said, I'm gonna have to do some cleaning. All right. Last but not least. Apple pie. I was kind of unsure about this one. Yeah. I love apple pie. I can't wait for Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving's gonna be so much fun. Oh my God. Ten out of ten. Wow, it tastes just like apple pie. Yep. If you're in Rhode Island, you can pre-order these. But my boyfriend said that when he got there like right when they opened, like, and there was no line because they're known for selling out and having really long lines. So that's exciting. So I just want to thank you guys so much for following me on this bikini prep journey during this whole series this year. I know I haven't been super perfect about posting, but you know, we're working on it. I'm busy. I got a work in progress. So going into the off season, I have lots of fun content and videos planned, lots of baking and cooking with protein and healthy, good deliciousness. Holidays are coming, so I'm gonna have some tips on Instagram and on here for how to get through the holidays and recipes for yummy stuff that you can bake and take to your holiday parties. That's not that healthy. That is healthy. Wow. I still have prep brain, if you can't tell. So there's gonna be workouts, all kinds of good content coming your way on this channel when I can be a little more creative, and then we are gonna follow the journey through the off season as we prep for our pro debut, which technically, I mean, we're not on prep yet, but as we go through our off season to get ready to prep for our pro debut next year. So if you've enjoyed this prep series, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, like this video, subscribe, leave me a comment down below. And just thank you so much for watching, and I can't wait to continue this journey through bodybuilding and just life. Life is good. I'm a pro. I can't believe I'm an OCB bikini pro. And if you don't know, OCB is an all-natural drug-tested federation. So it's really wonderful because, I mean, I take multivitamins and vitamins, supplements, pre-workout, hydration. So everything I take is very clean. A lot of my supplements, and they're all third-party tested to make sure there's nothing bad in them. So OCB, you have to take a polygraph test before you are even allowed to compete and pass questions about illegal substances. And then after you win your pro card, which I had to do on Saturday, you have to go pee in a cup and they send it to the lab. But I'm not worried about that because obviously all I take is supplements that are clean and obviously don't do drugs. So anyways, so that's a little bit on the background on that. I do want to compete in NPC, even though there are no regulations on there. I still wanted to just bring my best naturally and see how I do. So with that being said, again, thank you so much for watching and following this journey. And I'll see you in the next video, which will be an off-season protein pumpkin spice comparison test, taste test. So that'll be fun. And I will see you guys in the next one.